Let's start the first method of capital busting. We'll be starting this first with the traditional methods. In traditional methods, we'll be covering first is the payback period method. As the name says, payback period. Payback period method means how much time does it take for the investment to pay back itself? Very simple. You invested 1000 rupees also. You would like to know in how much time am I going to get 1000 rupees back, right? Now, shorter the payback period, we accept our project. Longer a payback period, we reject our project. So the exercise is simply rejection and acceptance is just based on one criteria. How fast you get back your money. I say to start a business, you get 10 lakh rupees. You're like, fine, 10 lakh is okay. But in what stage do I get back my 10 lakh back in the form of profits? So whatever method, see, we take into account is inflows and outflows, right? Cash inflows and cash outflows will be a matter of concern, whatever method we go about. Our perspective of seeing it will just change. For example, in payback period method, how much time does it take for to get back the investment back? Now, payback you can do for two. Payback can either be calculated for constant annual cash inflows or it can be calculated for uneven cash inflows. Constant, for example, when you assume, see, you're sitting today in base year. You haven't invested the money. You're just thinking, if I invest the money, what will happen when I start investing? You're sitting today in base year. Now you're seeing into future. You're looking into future and see when investment happens, what will your investment all about? For example, let us cover the first illustration. If I say now, you'll get constant profits every year. You make 10,000 investment, you'll get 2,000 every year profit. Right? Now, if you make 10,000 as the investment, if I say you get 2,000 profit every year, any idea in how many years are you getting back your investment? 5 years, right? 2,000 for first year, 2,000 for second, third, fourth, fifth. If you add back, how much is the payback period, you can say? 5 years, right? So what do we do when your cash inflows are same every year? You can use a formula. Only when your cash inflows are same. You can use a formula like annual investment divided by cash inflow. Or we can, what you can do directly, 10,000 divided by 2,000 gives you what? 5 years, right? So that is what annual cash inflows. You have a doubt? Let us do a small illustration together. Payback period method is just about how fast you get back your investment. For example, you can see this illustration. A project requires initial investment of 40,000. It will generate annual cash inflow of 10,000 for 6 years. You're required to find out the payback period. Now they're saying the 10,000 amount will be same every year, right? So in how many years will you get back your money? When the amount of profit is same every year, you can use a formula. As I said, investment is 40,000, profits are 10,000. So 40,000 divided by 10,000 is what? 4 years. It means it takes 4 years to get back my money. Now when you're comparing your projects, you saw in the last session, projects can be of various types. They can be independent, dependent, mutually exclusive. These methods, when I talk about accepting and rejecting, I'm talking about is mutually exclusive project. We need to select one and reject the other. So when I'm accepting one and rejecting the other, I'll accept the one with a shorter payback period. This is what you do when the cash inflows are same. Now it's not necessary now. The profits will be same every year. How you can be so sure that 10,000 will be the profit which you earn every year? So now we have a second illustration for that. In that case, you can't use a formula. Right? When the profits, if I say you get 2,000 in the first year, 3,000 in the second year, 4,000 in the third year. See, profit is not same. Your inflows are not same every year. When inflows are not same every year, what do we do then? Let us do a second illustration on this. As you can see from this, from the following information required to calculate payback period, a project requires an investment of 40,000. So we got one thing correct. How much we have a cash outflow? 40,000. And generate cash inflows of 16,000, 14,000, 8,000 and 6,000 in the years consecutively. Now, what do we need to see? In how many years do I get back my 40,000 rupees back? Now, if you see, cash inflows are not same. Your profits are not same. So just keep adding up. If you want, you can make one column for cumulative cash inflows. Now, for example, first year you get a profit of 16,000. Second year you get a profit of 14,000. 16 plus 14 gives you how much? 30,000. It means till second year you have you how much is your cumulative cash inflows? 30,000. Continue. And next year you made a profit of 8,000. So 30,000 plus 8,000 is 38,000. It means still we have not got a 40,000 back. Continue. Fourth year you get a profit of 6,000. So 38,000 plus 6,000 gives you how much? 44,000. It means now we have exceeded 40,000. And in third year, it's less than 40,000. So it means the answer is somewhere between the third year and the fourth year. Right? Now 3 years we are sure. that we are going to get back our money in 3 years. The rest of the amount must be in months. In how many months you are getting back your money? Now, how much is the difference? 40,000 minus 38,000 is how much? 2,000. So 2,000 will be your numerator. Denominator will be the profit of the next year, that is 6,000. So you'll get the answer in months. 3 years and 3 months, to be very precise, is a payback period. So if you want very approximate answers, and if the profits fall below, then you have to find out your cumulative cash inflows and go ahead with it. And this is how you do payback period method. Just we accept or reject that how fast we get back our money. Now this method has various advantages. You can see it's easy to understand, simple, just very simple. How fast am I getting back my money, right? Similarly, if you see, but this method covers from various disadvantages also. The major disadvantage of this method is that it ignores the time value of money. See, I'm sitting 0 year. If I say profit after first year will be 10,000, value of money will change, right? This method does not take into account is the time value of money. Second disadvantage of this method is that this method ignores the future cash inflows which might generate after your payback period. For example, if I still get back your money in 4 years, what happened after that? It just ignores. After fourth year, if you're getting a loss also, this method does not take into account that. Similarly, what if the investment amount is only different? Can you compare with this method? For example, if I project A requires investment of 10 lakh, project B requires 20 lakh, can you compare with payback? No, because investment amount is only different. Your outflows are not same. So it's not a viable method to compare if nothing is same in all the methods. And that's why payback period method led to the occurrence of other methods in future. The major disadvantage of payback was what? It ignores the time value of money. And because of this disadvantage, discounted payback period method came into existence.